Time to start a spooky edition of the calendar off with Halloween as we close out the area's bevy of October events and head on into November. Should be plenty of good stuff going on in November as well, including a first Friday, which means Gallery Walk. Gallery Walk does also have its own official website, so don't hesitate to click this link here if you want to find out more about any one of the bevy of events going on in the downtown and surrounding regions associated with Gallery Walk, any one of which might suit your interests, your families, your friends, who knows. Also, there's another series of events on our calendar linked to Gallery Walk. That includes the Brattleboro Film Festival, which is set to kick off tomorrow, Friday, November 1st, during Gallery Walk at 5 p.m. at the Latches Theater, where they'll screen previews for their upcoming movies, which include award-winning independent documentary, animated, comedic, dramatic, even Oscar-contending works. And for the next 2 weeks, they'll play more than 30 films going through their roster, all screening at the Latches. There's even two film noirs screening at the Brooks Memorial Library. But again, it all kicks off with their opening reception at the Latches Theater, where they will serve some light refreshments and beverages, along with letting you see all those trailers. You can also socialize with members of the festival. That's all at 5 p.m. at the Latches Main Theater this coming Friday, tomorrow, November 1st.
I think we always had the intention of being a bigger festival. Last year, we just launched it, a right. smaller thing, and it was very, very successful. So we were well on our way to having a much bigger festival this year, and we've really pulled it off.
Again, the Brattleboro Film Festival set to kick off tomorrow, November 1st at 5 p.m. at the Latches Main Theater for their opening reception, where they'll show previews for a number of the 30 films they plan to bring to the downtown region over the next 2 weeks. Now, to see which of those 30 movies might tickle your fancy, or find out how to volunteer and thus get to see one of these for free, or even how to donate and keep supporting the festival, you can visit their official website, BrattleboroFilmFestival.com. All right, we're going to stick on Friday, November 1st for a second, and head on down to the 7:30 block of time to check out one of the fall's most highly anticipated performances. It's called Resounding Hills, a transformative musical collaboration. And it'll see Kern Hatton students joined on stage by Hugh Keelan and the Wyndham Orchestra for a night of choral and instrumental pieces, all aimed at showcasing a spirit of mentorship and collaboration at Kern Hatton.
Well, the particular joy of this concert that we're doing, Enchanted Hills is what we're calling it, is that it's a collaboration between the Wyndham Orchestra and the kids at Kern Hatton. We're bringing lots of different collaborative strands together, local history, Kern Hatton and all the accomplishments that are going on up there, and the possibilities for the children and the possibilities for ourselves. There's something here for everybody.
Again, the concert is dubbed Resounding Hills. It's right here if you want the clickable link. And it all kicks off at 7:30 tomorrow, November 1st, on Kern Hatton Homes Westminster campus. Now, tickets are by donation at the door. For more clips on the event also, I'll mention you can check out BCTV on our official YouTube channel, youtube.com/BrattleboroTV. We've got a series of videos up now about this and about the Wyndham Orchestra and their upcoming season. Some BCTV insider clips, including interviews with Wyndham Orchestra maestro Hugh Keelan himself. All right, with that, we'll move on in the calendar here and talk a little bit about the Brattleboro Area Hospice Cherished Goods Auction. It's a benefit auction for Brattleboro Area Hospice, and it runs 5 to 8. So here's the clickable link for that. Going to fill the halls of the VFW in Brattleboro with good cheer, as the event's a patented mix of both silent and live auction items includes a new twist this year. The addition of hand-painted refurbished mirrors, which have been embellished by local artists and are now up for bid, alongside the auction's usual assortment of jewelry, paintings, china, glassware, decorative items, furniture. There'll be some exciting getaways in there, gift certificates, and plenty more.
We just had trucks pulling in and pulling product and volunteers in the store, and it was really remarkable to see the outpouring of support.
Well, that does it for the spooky edition of our BCTV video calendar here, but be sure to join us next week as we launch into a full new November cycle of upcoming events. And again, all of these are still clickable links for every last second that I chit-chat away here before the final white flash of light on the screen. You can also find extended clips if you want more than the 17 seconds allotted in the video calendar spotlight. We often put up video calendar extras on BCTV's YouTube channel, youtube.com/BrattleboroTV. And of course, all this goes up at brattleboroTV.org. We can find out how to subscribe, follow us on Facebook, get involved with BCTV, make your own show, and plenty more. In the meantime, thanks for watching.